DaVinci Resolve, either the Studio Edition or the free one, don't like being installed on modern Linux distributions. They are only officially supported on CentOS 7.3 and Rocky Linux 8.6. Some versions kinda sorta manage to run them anyways, with some hacks baked into the installer by Blackmagic Design. Others, such as Ubuntu 24.04, simply can't run. About 2 months ago, I published a video on my main channel on how to fix some of the problems. This got DaVinci Resolve to install and start, and even somewhat work. It was, however, very far from perfect. It required a ton of manual steps and a lot of typing. Worse, it only worked for some of the people in some of the configurations. Others got segmentation faults and other problems. Even on my system, where it did, in fact, work, it did not work flawlessly. Especially around Fusion, the program showed problems that didn't happen when running on Rocky Linux. So this video is a do-over. It's relatively simple. It should provide DaVinci Resolve with the same environment regardless of what your operating system is running, and it doesn't require a lot of typing. Before I begin the explanation, I need to point out a couple of things to keep in mind. First, YouTube does not allow me to update the video. If I find that something needs to be changed after posting it, I'll write about it either in the description of the video or in a pinned comment. As such, please make sure to read those before starting the procedure. The other thing is that I've only tested this procedure with a system running Xorg and with an NVIDIA GPU. Wayland and AMD GPUs may work, but I have not tested them. So without further ado, let's get to the actual procedure. The solution here involves two dev packages. One is called distro-run and is a new, very shallow container tool. It allows running a program in another distro while still maintaining a high level of interaction with your hosting OS, which DaVinci Resolve seems to need in order to function. The other dev is called DR Installer, which stands for DaVinci Resolve Installer. It provides a few scripts for setting up the environment and wrapping the installation, making the effort level much lower and less error-prone. The first step is to download the base DR installer deb file. The description of this video contains a link to a file called drinstaller0.00amd64.deb. Some browser configurations may warn when downloading it that this is a dangerous file. They're right. But we're still not giving it any power, so merely downloading it is not a problem. The reason this file is considered dangerous is because installing a deb file gives the code inside full access to your system. As such, you want to make sure it comes from a source you can trust. In this particular case, there are two questions you need to ask yourself. How do you know that the file you downloaded really came from me? And how do you know that I can be trusted? The standard way third-party providers solve one is by providing a signature file. I have done the same. The next line in the description is a link to downloading a file called drinstaller0.00amd64.deb.asc. This is a PGP signature file that makes sure that the first file you downloaded actually came from me. Actual verification needs to be done in the terminal. I promise you, that is the only step that needs you to type stuff out. We can type gpg --verify and then drag the ASC file into the terminal so it gets the path. Hitting enter tells us that it was signed with an unknown key and therefore cannot be verified. To verify the signature, we need the public key that signed it. Most providers, at this point, give you a third file to download, which is the public key. At best, this is pointless, and at worst, dangerous. If we don't trust the deb, how can we trust the key? To be effective, the key has to come from a source you already trust. Ubuntu, as well as almost all other Linux distributions using debs, are based on Debian Linux. Debian is a community distribution, which means that members of the community, called Debian developers, are entrusted to package software for inclusion in Debian. Most of that software trickles down, pretty much unmodified, to Ubuntu and the other distributions. If you install the Debian-derived distribution on your computer, you're trusting the Debian developers. And to make sure we know whom to trust, the public keys of all Debian developers is available in your distribution. So what we need to do now is install a package from the standard Ubuntu repositories called Debian Keyring. Once we do that, we can rerun the verify command, and this time tell it to use user share keyrings debian-keyring.gpg as the source of public keys. Do that, and you should see the message "Good signature from Shachar Shemesh." You're also getting a warning saying that GPG doesn't know where the actual key came from, and so does not know whether this key really belongs to the name written on it. Since we know this key came from a certified Ubuntu repository, we can ignore this warning. It should go without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. If GPG says anything other than "good signature," do not install the deb. Reach out to me and we'll try to figure out what happened. Once we've verified that the deb package is trusted, we can double-click it. A dialog opens up explaining what's in the package, and you can click Install to install it to the system. Once installed, the menus are unchanged. Nothing has happened. This is because the package you just installed does not contain any actual scripts. It may sound strange, but this was actually to make the installation simpler. The only thing the package did do is to add a signed APT source that links to a server I run. The actual package resides there. In order to get the actual scripts, we need to trigger an update cycle. As you may have noticed, I'm using KDE. For KDE, this is done with a tool called Discover. We go to the Update tab and ask to refresh. As a result, three new lines pop up asking to upgrade DR Installer from version 0.00 to a higher version. It also wants to install two brand new packages. We tell it to go ahead, and after a fairly short process, the upgrade is done. If we open the menu now, we finally see a new menu directory, DaVinci Resolve. Under GNOME and Unity, the directories may not appear, and you may need to seek out the files individually. My best offer to fix that is to install KDE and switch. I find GNOME unusable and don't know how Linux world seems to favor it. Under the DaVinci Resolve menu, we do not find the DaVinci Resolve installation, for the simple reason that I cannot, for copyright reasons, bundle it. The icons there are wrapper scripts for the three operations that may be needed. The first one to run is the Install Rocky Linux icon. It asks to elevate privileges, and then goes ahead to automatically install Rocky Linux 8.6 inside a directory on your hard disk. Specifically, the installation is under the SRV distros dr Rocky directory. The installation runs completely automatically. The only interaction needed from you is to hit Enter when it's done. With Rocky Linux installed, we can install DaVinci Resolve itself. You need to download the installer from the Blackmagic Design website and extract it yourself. Once you do, run the script called DaVinci Resolve Installer Wrapper. You will be greeted with a prompt asking for the path to the installation file. You can type it, but it's easier to just drag it into the window and press Enter. At this point, the usual graphical installation will start. Install it as usual. The only thing to keep in mind is not to change the installation path, even if prompted to do so, which it usually doesn't. You must install DaVinci Resolve to /opt/resolve. The standard installation asks to elevate privileges twice, once at the very beginning and once at the very end. Once that is done and you press Finish, you will be prompted a third time, this time from the wrapper script. It should finish quickly and you can press Enter to close the window. With the installation done, you should get a fully populated menu as well as a desktop icon. These can be run as usual. There's just one problem. At least for NVIDIA GPUs, it won't run. At this point, the explanation becomes a little technical. The reason is that this step needs to be repeated every so often. As such, I want you to recognize the error message and know the solution. The problem is that the NVIDIA drivers are installed on your host Ubuntu computer. Your rocky Linux installation does not have the drivers. However, you can get GPU error messages even if the rocky Linux container does have the drivers. NVIDIA requires that the version of the kernel module, shared between Ubuntu and Rocky, be exactly identical, down to the minor revision, to the user space libraries for which Ubuntu and Rocky Linux have separate installations. So every time the host driver changes, we need to resync the drivers to the Rocky Linux installation. Luckily, this is a relatively straightforward process. Just run the install NVIDIA driver script, put in the password, and then accept all defaults, i.e. hit enter until the installation is over. The script should auto-detect the driver version installed on the host, download that exact version from the NVIDIA site, and install it inside the Rocky Linux container. And with that, we're done. DaVinci Resolve loads and runs. In terms of hardware support, I only have the DaVinci Resolve editor keyboard and the speed editor keyboard, but both work fine, including firmware upgrades. If you want to manually review the Rocky Linux installation, you can do so by running distro run /bin/bash. This command will maintain user groups, environment, and work directory between caller and container. This means that if you want to make changes to the Rocky Linux installation, you need to become root prior to calling distro run. Unlike Docker and most other container tools for Linux, any change you make persists to future invocations. There's just one more caveat I need you to know about. On my installation, I've placed the video files in a separate partition on the disk. This means they are in a separate mount point, with a symbolic link making sure they can be found. DaVinci Resolve runs inside a container that only gets to see the directories we explicitly tell it are needed. If I follow this procedure and then try to load an existing project, all media will appear offline. If that is also the case for you, you need to do two things. First, create the same relative directories inside the container. Next, edit /etc/distro/run/drrocky.conf and add the directories you want visible to the Rocky Linux configuration. This will make sure these directories are visible inside the container. Originally, I planned to go over the technical side of the solution. What's actually going on behind the scenes, why the Docker solution didn't work, etc. This video, however, is quite long enough already, and I'm quite behind on my main channel schedule. So, we'll stop here. Thank you for watching.